In this video, we will explore the RStudio interface. First, the Options menu will be introduced and you'll see how to personalize the appearance of the interface. Then we will cover some details pertaining to the four main windows of RStudio. Let's begin by opening the program. Now don't be alarmed if you have a newer version of R appearing in your console. Here, I have version 3.3.1. R is routinely updated a couple or so times each year. You can personalize the look and feel of RStudio via the Options menu, which can be accessed by clicking Tools, Global Options, and then Appearance. Among the things that you can change are the font type, the font size, and then there are a number of editor themes from which you can choose. As you're clicking on each of these to see what they look like, notice that there is a preview pane that automatically pops up. If you scroll down, you'll see that there are also other options. In addition to the different background colors, RStudio also uses color to help identify key words associated with the R coding language, as you can see by the changing colors of the if statements, the commented lines, variable assignments, etc. Now, over the course of these videos, you'll learn more about these keywords. For now, just choose a color theme that seems easy on your eyes, but something that's, well, easy to read also. I prefer to use Tomorrow Night Bright. Remember, you can always change this later. But enough about these color themes. Let's click OK and return to our interface. There are four main windows in RStudio. However, there are only three the first time you open the software. This is because there's no scripts open yet. You can think of scripts as your personal files, like Word documents. Within these scripts, you can write your lines of R code. So you can write your lines, you can edit your lines, and you can also share these scripts with others. To open a new script, click on the Add New File icon, which is located in the upper left portion of your screen. And from the drop-down, you can click on RScript to open up a new script. Now, alternatively, you could also use Control-Shift-N as a keyboard shortcut. So now that we have a new script open, you can now see RStudio's four main windows. You have the Editor window, the Environment window, the Viewer window, and then the Console. Let's first take a look at the Editor, which is also sometimes referred to as the Scripting window. Here, you can build your collection of commands into a single file. You can easily run your code either line by line, in sections at a time, or execute all lines of code at once. So I'm going to open an example script to illustrate this. To open up a script, I can go to File, Open File, and I already had this listed on my desktop as a sample script. Now notice, once I opened this new script, it opened another tab right next to the untitled script. And this is what is very nice about the RStudio interface, is that you can have a number of scripts open, yet they're nicely organized up here in the editor pane. Let's see how to run a single line of code. One thing you can do is to highlight the line, hit run, and notice it created the height variable, and it's located up here in the environment window. It also appeared down here in the console showing you what's been executed. Now, another way you can run a single line of code is to have your cursor on the line upon which you want to execute, and then use Control Enter together to execute the line. Notice the same thing happened, except now we have ID in our workspace. You don't have to run everything line by line. You can also run sections of code. For example, if I were to highlight this entire section here, because it all pertains to producing a graph, then hit run, notice it executes that all in one go. Nothing more was created over here in our environment, but down here in our plots from our viewer pane, we can see that now we have our plot visible. Let's say that we wanted to run all of this at one time. You can either highlight all of this and then run through the same steps as before, clicking the run button. Or if this is a very long script, you can use the shortcut Control A to highlight everything, then hit run. Keep in mind that saving scripts allows you to share your code with other people. So keeping everything organized in your script is going to be very important. That means being able to make changes, save them accordingly. Let's say that I did make a change to this script. For example, let's say I wanted to add the comment. So use the pound symbol to comment. This is a histogram. Since I made this change, I can tell that it needs to be saved to keep it in its current form. I can tell this because the title is written in red and there's an asterisk now after the title. So to save this file as it is, it already exists, so I could hit the Save button, or I could go to File, Save or Save As, depending upon whether you wanted to keep the name or rename it. Now the Environment window, as we just pointed out, is the place where we have all of our variables, our data sets, our functions, etc. to be stored. This is also known as your workspace. You also have this History tab. Here you will have access to all the commands that you have executed, whether they be in the console or up in your scripting window. Now R will prompt you upon closing your session if you want to save your workspace. However, by default, R will save your console commands and executed lines of code as part of your history file. Below your environment window is the viewer window. Here, there are many tabs from which you can choose a number of options, including files, which you can think of as a Windows Explorer for PC, plots, where you can cycle through the plots that you've created. So from the example script, if we cycle back, you can see that there are two scatter plots. One was from the first call, the second is from when we ran the entire script, and then the histogram. The next is going to be packages, which you could think of as collections of scripts which people put online, and then you can download these for your own personal use. Then there's help, where you can find R documentation on just about anything in R. Notice also that there is a search box for your convenience. So if we were to put in mean, we would come up with the mean function. Or, for example, if I put in ABS, we'll see that that is one of the math functions. And there will be a description, how to use this, arguments, and some other details. The final tab is the viewer tab, which is mostly used for additional viewing of some web-related content that you can use in R as well. The final window is going to be the console, or sometimes referred to as the command prompt. Here you can type and execute commands similar to what you would be doing in the editor, which is right above it, except here in the console you're more interested in executing single lines of code rather than compiling multiple lines into a full script. You can think of the console window as a playground. Here you can try out your ideas and even assign content as variables to be saved in your workspace. And think of the editor as a window where you can eventually save these lines of code that actually do what needs to be done. And you can also save them for later use. For example, if I were to type in, I want to save T as being the values 3 through 8, notice that it would be saved to the environment. Then maybe I want to also create U, which is using T, then it also is saved in the history and in our workspace. But maybe I want to keep these two pieces, so I can copy them, bring them up to our script, and then paste them in. So you can see that there's a functionality between jumping from the console, where you can play around with different things, and then eventually bring them up to the script for either saving them or to continue editing until you have a full script the way that you would like to keep it. It's also worth mentioning that you can use the up and down arrows on your keyboard to cycle through the history of your executed commands. So if I'm down here in the console and I arrow up, notice there's U, there's T, and if I keep going, you can see all of the other commands which were executed, and if I go back down, I can go to where we were originally at. Another thing worth noting is that if you use Control L, it will completely clear the console. But that does not mean that you've lost all of your commands in your history. Notice if I arrow up, I still have those two commands as well as the others. And if I go back down, I'm right back to where I started. So this concludes the introduction to the RStudio interface. Thank you for watching. and happy coding.